My goal was being in the Olympics, winning a gold medal, which I thought I was getting pretty close, but unfortunately things just ended for me a little too soon.
Sinead Miller had been on two wheels most of her life.
So I started racing BMX when I was 4, and I also started racing dirt bikes when I was the same age. My helmet was bigger than my whole body whenever I was around 16 or 17. Went full-time professional road cycling, started traveling the world.
Sinead Miller.
The pedal power was grueling, but the national championships kept coming.
Out there killing yourself every day on the bike and in races. You know, the adrenaline rushes that you get by bombing 60 miles an hour down hills. I love the competitiveness of it.
I'm off next to Holland in this next week to start racing again.
But a crash at that road race changed everything.
It was more towards the end of the race, which is always more dangerous because everyone's fighting for position. I don't remember anything. I don't know how I crashed. I broke a lot of my facial bones and I broke my neck. I suffered a traumatic brain injury. I really identified with cycling. I mean, it's what I did my whole life.
Sinead needed a new passion.
And so I decided I wanted to do something where I could, you know, make a positive impact on the health, the lives of other people.
So after finishing a Ph.D. in biomedical engineering at Vanderbilt University, Sinead turned to research. She has developed a new way to treat sepsis, an infection that kills 250,000 Americans each year.
So you would hook this device up into a machine like a dialysis pump machine, but you would have a line like this line connected to the actual patient, and then you would be flowing that patient's blood into the device, and the device itself captures and removes all the bacteria and pathogens that cause sepsis.
With Department of Defense and National Science Foundation funding, Sinead hopes to start clinical trials in 2020. But still, her brain injury is a challenge in her life.
I get migraines every day, fatigue, dizziness, blurred vision. I see improvements every single year, but it's very small.
Now, back on a bike, she is dreaming again.
It's still my true passion. I would love to get back and race again.